dignity and respect for seniors in state housing programs. I'm Jill Horner. This is Comcast Newsmakers. With me this hour is New Jersey State Assemblyman Angel Fuentes. Thanks for being with us.
Thank you for inviting me.
This is legislation that was recently signed into law related to seniors in state housing programs. Talk to us a little bit about the catalyst behind this, because this actually arose out of complaints that the state was receiving.
Absolutely. For seniors who are really, most vulnerable and who reside in these state housing throughout the state of New Jersey, I've gotten complaints. When they get treated unfairly for just simple stuff, meal preparation, even just to take them to shopping, for instance, or to the laundry, and they get mistreated, I think it... It's a huge unjust, for them to be treated, because they actually paved the way for many of us with, like you mentioned, respect and dignity, and we owe that to them. So I feel very good, very comfortable in supporting this bill, Assembly 409.
So now that this has been signed into law, You say this is almost a bill of rights for senior citizens who do live within these housing programs. Talk to us a little bit about what this actually includes and how this could potentially benefit seniors down the line.
I think it puts the workers, even the volunteers, on guard. And someone might just probably had a bad experience at home, and then where did you go to work? That anger, if you will, is probably reflected in the workplace. But when you're dealing with seniors, they don't deserve to be mistreated. So it's just to say, they could be our moms and dads. They could be, grandparents. We need to show our respect to them. They have done so much for us for so many, decades, and we owe that to them. So it's really putting the workers and the volunteers on guard to say, when you come in and work, particularly with the senior citizens, and this great state, come with show respect and of course, love and caring, and that's what all they ask for. So when it comes to even to take them to do the laundry or to even shopping, for instance, if you're going to provide transportation to and from. So this Bill of Rights, it gives that protection to our senior citizens.
Now, when we talk about this is going to be available for seniors, as we mentioned, it's been signed into law, but actually housing service programs will also have to provide information to seniors about some of the services and programs that are available to them as well.
Sure, and that's our intention. We need to now go out throughout the 5th District and educate probably a lot of these CEOs, to let them know that this is now in effect. And I'm looking forward to even go to some of these housing projects to say to the seniors, guess what? This bill is now a law, and we're here to protect you. And we thank you, for really paving the way to many of us.
Now, this is not to say that these workers in these programs were all doing a bad job. We're talking about some isolated incidents that had come to your attention and to other legislators' attention. But if incidents do occur in the future, will there now be penalties in place?
Well, that's the responsibility of the CEO, the president, or the executive director. It is their responsibility, of course. And even if there's abuse, they need to contact the prosecutor's office from that county. I feel good knowing that, we introduced a bill that was signed by the governor that would really provide the utmost respect for our senior citizens and protect them. That's the bottom line.
And we just have a few seconds left, but this is something now in effect, and you're working to educate seniors and these housing programs throughout the district.
That's correct.
Thanks so much for being
with
us. We've been talking with New Jersey State Assemblyman Angel Fuentes. I'm Jill Horner.